Our election process is the pride of India. And yet, it's ironical that any time there is a significant election, two three-letter words face controversy. One is EVMs, and second is ECI, Election Commission of India, which owns these electronic voting machines and conducts elections with them in a super efficient, super fast manner, which is the envy of the whole world. So who do I have with me on Walk the Talk as my very special guest?
Morning.
Mr. Naseem Zaidi, Chief Election Commissioner.
Morning.
You are enjoying this fame and controversy, I can see.
Thank you very much for being here in this iconic building.
Yes, sir. You know, I love this. I think this setting is beautiful.
It represents voters actually of the country.
Voters are from various communities
diversity.
In various parts of the country.
Yes.
Diversity of India, yes.
Yes.
And it's a wonderful setting to have in Election Commission of India's
yes.
entrance.
We created these structures so that we can represent diversity.
Right.
Voters are our focus
right.
points, and we value our voters. We enjoy the trust, we enjoy the confidence, and we will continue to enjoy that.
And you enjoy the controversies also?
Well, we deal with controversies in a very truthful manner, in a very genuine way, and based on facts. And it will regenerate, it will enhance, and it will restore the confidence.
Right. But is some confidence lost, you think?
Well, Election Commission of India is full of confidence, is full of energy, and is ready to face these challenges which are coming up in the current time.
But is any confidence lost in public opinion, you think?
Well, some people have tried to kind of affect the trust and confidence of voters. But I think the way we are going to deal with this issue and the way it has been handled in past years, I don't think our voters are very, very careful, very, very cautious, very intelligent. I don't think they are going to lose any confidence in our electoral process.
But sir, there is a technophobia that, you know, people watch movies. People also see the power of, people see WikiLeaks, that one person hacking can get billions and billions of documents, hundreds of thousands of gigabits of data. So people have the same fear that because these are machines with computerized chips, maybe you can do something somewhere.
Well, one common argument or controversy which has been generated for past so many years is that our machine can be hacked. So I think this has been clarified a number of times before, and I once again clarify that our machine is not a computer. Our machine is a elevated or improved calculator. It is not a computer.
I see.
And if it is not a computer, it is not connected to any internet connections. There is no connectivity. Our machine is standalone.
Each machine
is standalone. It has only two components, one ballot unit, one control unit, and they are connected by a cable.
And there is a chip.
And there is a chip inside whose source code is not known to anybody. It is stored under controlled condition. Therefore, our machine is not a computer. Therefore, our machine is not amenable to hacking. And therefore, this argument that is being raised around that it can be hacked is, I think, totally baseless.
And what will happen if a government were to ask you to do something, to fix an election?
I don't think, I mean, the kind of reputation this building enjoys, this is an island within the
right.
within the country, I don't think ever any government...
Well, that's the reason we decided to record here in spite of the traffic noise.
Yes.
And I'm grateful you came so early in the morning.
No, I once again repeat that this is an iconic place. This is an island of independence and autonomy. I don't think any government would ask this structure here to do anything with the electoral process. And I don't think people sitting here would ever agree to do this. Because after all, this is the integrity, this is the conscience. We are protecting democracy.
Right.
And we are strengthening the electoral democracy.
So how do you feel when these allegations are made? Do you feel amused? Do you feel angry? Do you feel disappointed? Do you feel a bit of all of the above?
No, I won't say that I feel angry or anybody sitting in this building feel angry or anybody feels very passionate in terms of reacting angrily. I think we deal with the issues as and when they come before us. We have umpteen number of technical data, umpteen number of administrative facts with us, and we can deal with these challenges. I think the process has been going on and we will continue with this process. if there is an improvement needed, we will do it.
But sir, what about all these people who keep coming up saying, I demonstrated in a press conference that these machines can be hacked. I think Kuldeep Bishnoi has said this most recently, last evening, with some pictures. Dr. Subramaniam Swamy said this in the past. Various people keep coming up saying, see, I demonstrate hacking to you.
Well, these challenges were made earlier also. And if you recall, in 2009, the commission had opened for 10 days and thrown a challenge. Anybody could walk in here and manipulate our machine. We opened the machine, we showed the components of the machine, but they insisted, as I have read in the literature here, they insisted that they would like to take this machine. And if they take this machine away, then it is not our machine.
Right.
So we say that ECI, EVM, under our possession, under our security, under our safety, you manipulate here in the presence of our technical staff, but nobody has been able to do it here.
So the next question, that if you are so sure, you've now started this VVPAT, as it's called.
Yes,
voter
this is
verifiable. It's a bit of a tongue twister,
but paper audit trail.
Paper audit trail. So why don't you just count these slips and match them with votes?
Well, you see, the whole electoral process functions under a legal framework.
Constitutional and legal.
Constitutional framework. And the law made by the parliament. And therefore, now more or now it is settled, it is provided in our law also that EVM will also have VVPATs. Supreme Court has also given the order that
voter verifiable paper audit trail.
Yes, VVPAT. Voter verifiable, something which voter can verify. And it leaves
so after the voter votes, she can check ki mera theek jagah gaya ke nahi.
Yes, you are right.
Right.
Jab voter compartment mein jata hai, to wahan par jab wo button press karta hai, then there is a machine there,
right,
which is VVPAT. It's a small printer, highly sophisticated printer. And when he presses the button, he can see on the window whether his vote has gone to the right candidate. So VVPAT has to be used now. Supreme Court has asked us to do it in a phased manner. We are asking for funds from the government. It will require over 3,000 crore rupees. So far, we have purchased more than 52,000 machines.
How many do you need overall?
Well, we will need as many as EVMs. That means close to 1.5 million. That means 15 lakhs, yeah. Around 15 lakhs.
So right now you only have about 3% of what you need.
Well, we have only 52,000,
right.
And we have also committed to the Supreme Court recently, in this month only, that we will take 30 months time to produce that many VVPATs from the date of release of funds, and we are pursuing very relentlessly with the government.
Has the government delayed funds for this?
Well, we are pursuing it, I can't say. I think there is a need to release those funds immediately,
right,
so that we go in for production, produce them within 30 months and start using them. My statement last year also was that in 2019, we will use VVPATs at all polling stations in the country, and given the time frame of about 24 months available now for 2019 elections, I think still a very large percentage of polling stations.
If money is made available.
If money is made available today.
So what is the government telling you? Do they have the money or do they not have the money?
Well, government has money. They should provide it to us.
So they are not deliberately trying to deny it. So
I can't say that. I can't say that because the matter is also being monitored by the Honorable Supreme Court.
Right.
I think it will come up in hearing in this month only. We have said that we are ready to use the machine. There is a legal framework, there is a full commitment of the Election Commission, and we are committed to use VVPAT. And this will be again a game changer. You mentioned in the beginning whether there is a loss of confidence. I think our use of VVPATs with EVM will, I think, double and treble the confidence of the people.
Then, sir, why are you not counting, as Mr. Kejriwal is demanding, VVPATs in the places where you've used it, so in Punjab, and matching them with voting results of those
See,
places?
According to our law, when the counting starts and when the counting is finished, then under law, the candidate or his agent can ask for recount. if that opportunity has not been availed of, then that opportunity is gone. And second point is that when the counting is over, then the jurisdiction of the Election Commission shifts from Article 324 of the Constitution to the Article 329, which falls under High Courts. And therefore, if you have not asked for recount, then you cannot ask for recount, because now it is a matter between...
So then for a recount, you have to go to the court?
Yes, you have to file an election petition.
I see.
And another interesting aspect of law is that you cannot ask for recount in the entire general elections.
Right. In a seat.
Like you cannot ask for a recount of entire state. Each candidate, or as per the law, an election petition has to be filed, and then High Court's jurisdiction starts and they decide.
So see, the remedy for Aam Aadmi Party in Punjab, if they feel deeply aggrieved, is that in each seat where VVPATs were used,
yes,
their candidate should file an election petition,
yes,
and ask for receipts to be matched with votes.
Whatever they want to ask, they have to ask from the...
But this remedy is available.
Because at this point in time, Election Commission cannot even touch the stronghold.
So you cannot deliver that remedy?
Yes.
Only the courts have that remedy.
The remedy we are delivering is that our process is full of integrity.
So if they go to court asking for this, will you oppose it?
No. Election Commission always stands to assist the court.
Right.
See, in the election petitions, the standing rulings are that Election Commission is not...
A party.
We are not playing an adversarial role.
Right.
We are there to assist the court, and whenever the court will ask us to make machines available, to assist the court in counting, we will do it. Our legal advisor, Mehndi Ratta, has been going to court.
Yes, in fact, we featured him on Walk the Talk.
Yes, one of the talks.
Because I think he's a mini institution within an institution.
So
he has been going
to the courts and assisting the courts in undertaking very complex counting processes.
Right.
Particularly under proportional representation.
Right.
So if there are petitions, if courts ask to... for commission to assist them, we will do that.
Right. So, sir, there are politicians and politicians and politicians. The strongest objection this time has come from one of our best educated politicians, and best educated technically. IIT education is also a gold standard in engineering education. So, Mr. Kejriwal is a distinguished IIT graduate, very well reputed. What's your advice to him?
Well, you see, the commission has on board some of the finest brains of IITs, as you mentioned. We have a technical evaluation committee, and there are four eminent professors working here. We are working very closely with them. In fact, they are our technical advisors. I mean, our general advice to anyone who has any doubt about the process is now to seek remedy under the legal framework through the election petitions. And our advice is that another point that I would like to mention is that the election process has been going on for some time now, and we have organized multiple checks with these EVMs in the presence of political parties, their representatives. You know, there is a process in our election commission which is called mock polls, first level checks, then there are multiple sealings. And these are all conducted in the presence of political parties. Political parties put their signatures on those seals. They are allowed to conduct mock polls, thousands of votes. Our issue is that during this entire process, nobody has raised that there is a defect in the EVM machine. And now, post-counting, after all results have been announced, saying that our EVMs were defective, I don't think...
Nobody complains after they win.
Well, this is what we have seen. This is what we have seen in past 17 years. Yeah.